Welcome back to my channel. If induction cooker is not producing enough heat, it is providing low heat, what are the checkpoints? What are the reasons? Let's discuss. This is a question from my viewer, that what are the reasons, how we can determine where is the problem, what are the checkpoints? We have AC voltage, line, neutral, then we have a bridge rectifier. Positive and negative voltage are reaching here to a capacitor, that is this one. Here is bridge rectifier, we have capacitor here. Then these voltage are reaching to a tank circuit, that is here induction coil, resonant coil and resonant capacitor, two things. And these negative voltage are reaching to IGBT, whatsoever, IGBT MOSFET, whatsoever. And we apply signal here at the gate. Now this is point to understand. How it will switch? It will take a gate drive signal. From where? From the gate driving network, that are these components. Here it is showing two IGBTs in parallel, one and two. In some induction cookers there are four IGBTs. Some induction cookers have two IGBTs. That is based on the power, how much power rating it is using. It will give a pulse. Just only it will give a pulse here. It will cause to flow the current in this winding. So it will cause to flow the current. Then zero crossing detector, that are two resistors, resistor networks are connected here to apply the feedback signal. ZCD, zero crossing detector. When this pulse will reach here, this is called resonant circuit. Then it will reach again at 0 degree, it will create another pulse. Our function is here, that when it will provide a pulse, it will cause to flow the current in this winding. After that, at that time, it will charge this capacitor in this portion, and then it will discharge it in the winding. We provided a pulsed voltage. This current will not flow all the time. It will just only give a pulsed current through this winding to this capacitor. Here it's positive, negative. So this current will flow here. The voltage stored in this capacitor will flow here. In my videos, I discuss electronic current. So electronic current flows from negative terminal to positive terminal. If you are discussing conventional current, that is from positive terminal to negative terminal, the same way. No problem. So the current flow from negative terminal to the positive terminal, it will build magnetic fields. Here we have some core, that is our cooktop. It will create magnetic field in the base of that cooktop, that is iron core. And it uses eddy current, so the maximum current will flow in the base of the cooktop. It will cause to create heat in the base of the cooktop. How much magnetic field we are creating here? It will depend on this pulse, the first thing, this circuit, our cooking profile, which we are selecting from the front panel, from here. And our zero crossing detector network, that is combination of these capacitors and resistors. In some induction heaters, there is separate operational amplifier used to detect zero crossing detector. But here, it will detect directly to the analog pins, CP on, CP OP. So it will detect the pulses. As we are seeing here, it is using operational amplifiers. zero crossing detector. So zero crossing pulse will reach here, it will go to the microcontroller, microcontroller will generate the next pulse. Now come to the reasons. That is the biggest issue in this network, that is this capacitor. Because the most problematic or most common failure component in the electronics, that is capacitor. So our resonant capacitor, number one. Number two, the smoothing capacitor. Resonant capacitor. Number three, the problem in these three transistors that are gate driving network. The microcontroller produces a pulse PPG, that is here. This pulse, it will drive to gate to the base of this transistor. At that time, it will switch this transistor and positive voltage will go to the gate of IGBT. It will switch. If our this transistor have reduced its gain, it will switch later. At that time, it will give delay time in the switching, so it will cause to a delayed switching, which will not allow to build the proper magnetic field in the winding. So we need to verify 1, 2, 3, these transistors. And the resistors here, these are also very important. Then the voltage here at the collector, that are 18 volt from this power supply, from the buck regulator here. And these voltage must be stable from this capacitor. These must be stable. If these 18 volt are not stable, it will also cause to give a disturbed pulse. Sometime the pulse level will high, sometime low. So we need to check these 18 volts. We need to check this capacitor, that is resonant capacitor, this capacitor, and sometime the soldering here, it also causes to increase the contact resistance between the tracks and the IGBT. If there is slightly high resistance, it will cause to drop the more voltage in the bad joints. So in that case, we need to desolder and resolder again. Here we have a shunt. Then the next most common cause in this circuit, that is overcurrent detector circuit. If you see in the circuit diagram, we have a shunt resistance here that we discussed here, that this shunt resistance is here from this point to this point, and its feedback is going to the processor. That is this resistor, that is going to PA7, programmable pin number 7, that is here. Then we have a variable resistor here, that is to adjust the current limit, that is here. We need to verify, because its two pins are jumpered together, and it is just only variable resistance, and it is calibrated. Never bypass this safety, just verify. You can try by adjusting it, but never remove it, because if we remove it, we will bypass the safety current limit, that is 251 ohms. It is total 500 ohms. Never bypass this one. If you look at this shunt, so the voltage dropped across this shunt resistance, it is to measure the overcurrents. Most of the time it don't have any problem, just we have problem in the shunt, in the soldering. If its contact resistance is increased, it will cause to increase more voltage, because when the current is increased, slight change, very little change in the resistance will cause to increase in the voltage. So just only desolder it, then resolder it again. Check the resistor here, between, that is between this 1 kilo ohm resistor. It is a voltage dropper resistor, then these voltage are reaching here. Then this preset, this potentiometer is providing the signal to this microcontroller, so it will sense the current. The next problem, if we have more gap between the induction coil and this ceramic plate due to any reason. If we have more gap, to cover the gap issue, we can also try a washer here in these mountings, between mounting and the base of this induction coil. It can also be a reason. The next, if we replace induction coil, if it is not copper based, if the original coil is damaged and we replace with some coil and that is not a copper winding, that is silver wire. Silver wire is also available in the market. If we are using silver wires, it will not create a proper magnetic field. That can also be a reason. So it is, as per my analysis, if you have some idea about this issue, kindly let me know in the comment. I will be thankful. These are the possible reasons which we can say this circuit that is here. This shunt resistance, if our these voltage are fail, fluctuating, these will cause to produce disturbed pulse here. If our gain for these transistors is bad, this problem. If this VR, variable resistor, it is bad, if this variable resistor is bad or its resistance is increased or decreased, we can adjust by decreasing this resistance slightly, 1/8 turn, and check it. Never make a jumper or never increase the resistance. If we will increase the resistance, what we'll do, we will damage this IGBT. If we will bypass this one by increasing the resistance, if it is 250 ohms resistance now at this time, if we will set it to 500 ohms or 1 kilo ohm, what we will do, we will reduce the feedback signal. If we will reduce the feedback signal, we will damage this IGBT. Why the feedback is decreased? We have to sort out the reason. Might be the soldering, might be something other. We have to find out the problem. Check this resistance. If it is 1 kilo ohm, because it is in heat area surroundings. Here is heat generating components, the IGBT and the bridge rectifier. Maybe this resistor is devalued. If its resistance will increase, it can also cause to change the feedback pulse. So we need to verify these components. If you have some other experience, some other idea about this issue, please let me know in the comment box. I hope so you enjoyed this video. If it is good, if it is informative, hit the like button. Thanks for watching. Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.